Nice little wintry mood, even though it's like 70 degrees out here in New York City. So we're waiting for the drafts to come in from both of these teams. We're going to be starting off here on Dragonshire, which, Zoya, while you're listening, make sure that if we're ever doing Haunted Minds to remind me that we need to... I need to lower my lighting settings if we ever do Haunted Minds.
Okay, I'll try and remember. Make no promises. The tweet is out, everybody, so if you're following myself or Kevin on Twitter, you can retweet from us.
Tweeter. Okay. Well, I just retweeted you.
Oh, snap.
Oh, yeah. All right. So we are waiting for the picks and bans. Match this round are Dragon Knight, Cursed, Haunted, Reddit Thread hadn't updated. I don't think Reddit Thread hadn't updated is a map, but maybe
you're the worst. You are the worst. The puns and the jokes.
Could you imagine a Reddit Thread map? What would it be like? Like, if suddenly if you cast a spell twice, you're considered a reposter and you're banned? Give a half and half shot of whether or not...
Sorry, I was typing. I got
distracted. I noticed you were typing, because I could hear...
No, like, it would be like kind of like the Plant Terror map, where
you have to gather
you're killing
upvotes?
These minions, but there's a chance they drop downvotes, and anytime you get a downvote, like, something bad happens, but you want to collect upvotes. There will be custom games where you can make your own maps and stuff, guys. So...
Alright, guys, well, drafting phase is about to begin. But, yeah, Reddit map. Make it happen, community.
Make it happen.
I'm not smart enough to make something like that, you know, make a map. I remember I used to try to make maps in StarCraft Brood War. I used to sit in my room, blasting Tools Anima, and, like, try and make maps, and it never happened. Alright, so first ban coming out is Arthas.
Yep, what did I say in the Gillyweed interview? What did I say?
They were listening.
Ban that Arthas.
Dino, releasing out think, the like, secret strats here, Zoya. I don't know.
I'm actually gonna look up Hotslogs real quick and see how many games Dino has played on Arthas. Ban Tassar, solid ban, so there is Dino's account. He is actually the fifth highest MMR, and he has 162 out of 169 games played on Arthas.
Wow.
That's
a lot of Arthas.
It's probably
about half as much as I have on Diablo, but that's a lot of Arthas.
Yeah, he's played an insane amount of Arthas.
So first again, pick from Snowflake is going to be Tyrael, which is interesting. That's a very weird first pick. Obviously going to be going on LZ Gamer. He loves that Archangel. He loves to throw down some justice. It's how they're going to be synergizing around that Tyrael pick, whether or not they're going to be running like with a very strong team to support that. Look at that, LZ not even showing any shame, just be like, yeah, it's me.
Pick Kerrigan, Uther. Uther is a really solid pick. Kerrigan is in a really weird spot right now. A lot of people still think she is good, not as good. It's kind of like that weird situation where some people think Barb is better, and some people think Kerrigan is better. She's definitely not bad, but for lower level players, she's definitely much harder to play.
Mm-hmm. I can see that. And you know, she did get nerfed, and we saw a lot less picking of her lately. But it's good to see that you know somebody is at least first picking her for their team. And with Uther, that's actually a really strong early game presence. So they might be just trying to get those early levels and try and like out level Snowflake. Tychus, Falstad now coming down here from Snowflake. Both two really strong ranged heroes. Probably going to be seeing a support and either a specialist or a strong tank coming out here from Snowflake in their last picks.
Yeah.
Maybe Brightwing or Rhaegar. Because this right now
forces... I wouldn't be
surprised
at Brightwing.
Huh?
I wouldn't be surprised if it's Brightwing, because Snowflake has a history of running Falstad Brightwing.
Yeah, and especially against a Kerrigan, that's going to be a really strong counter pick. And as well
that's
as...
A point. That's a really good point, actually.
Yeah, and but the only thing is that Rhaegar would be a really good synergy with that Tychus. But it's not, you know, it's not to ruin the synergy of countering the enemy team if you have to force in that Rhaegar in there. That actually kind of weakens your team. So you have to be a little bit careful of whether or not you want to focus on making your team stronger or taking away... What are those picks?
So, this is like a highly debated thing. I think it's split between the community. A lot of people think Abathur's worst map is Haunted Mines, and a lot of people think Abathur's worst map is Dragonshire. I personally think it's more toward the Dragonshire side. And when I say worst map, that doesn't mean Abathur's not bad at any map at this point. Abathur is so good right now. I think he might be in the top four heroes of the game right now, just because he can be utilized so well. But that Anub pick is really interesting to me. That's the one that kind of threw me off the most. Well, we already have the hard engage with Kerrigan.
Yeah, so this is going to be a really hard engage team. And imagine, you know, you have Uther with Uther running, you know, Kerrigan, Anub, initiate. Uther runs in, Divine Storms, Kerrigan's Maelstrom still going, Anub just able to just do absolutely everything and wreck house. And then Abathur can just pick whatever the heck he wants. Now, I'm curious to see... Oh, and that's exactly what I was expecting before. Seeing the support and the heavy tank. So we're seeing a Chen come out here on LZ.
LZ's Chen is so nasty, man. I love watching LZ's Chen. His early game, if he's in like a 1v1 lane, he's like unstopped. Like, you just can't out... You can't beat him. He's just unkillable. And then he's so good with... I always forget the name of it. The ult.
Storm, Earth, and Fire.
Storm, Earth, and Fire.
Earth, Storm, and Fire. Earth, Fire, and Storm.
Something like that.
Earth, Wind, and Fire. Ba-doo, ba-doo.
I would like to see a... Stitches?
What?
They have no damage.
Okay, now that's just...
I was about to say, I would like to say Rainer over Vala, but...
That just blew my mind, because they have a really hard engage team, and then they have the opposite pick, which is a Stitches, which is he's not... a strong engager. He can pick, and he can get that pick and give you the advantage, but for the strong engagements with Kerrigan and Anubarak, that's a really weird synergy that they're working with, but hey, maybe it's gonna work.
Abathur is gonna have to be the real damage on their team. Who do you think Abathur will be? I mean, it'll be situational, but I think we'll be seeing Abathur either heroicking Anub or Uther for the most part. Unless they're wanting to do cheeky Abathur Stitches stuff.
Who knows, man? I mean, right now, I'm actually completely confused as to what their choice is going to be for this.
Yeah. This is going to be a really weird game. They have no real hard carry damage. Kerrigan can put up some decent numbers if she's not focus fire down, which, honestly, on that entire team... That is who you're going to kill every time, is the Kerrigan. And that's really their best damage. I mean, Anubarak can get some good numbers, but not as good as Kerrigan. And we'll have to see. Let's just get into introductions. In the blue trunks here on Dragonshire, left side of the map, we have Team Snowflake Idra on Tychus, Faye on Falstad, Keelax on Brightwing, Chilatek on Tyrael, and LZ Gamer on Chen.
All right, and over on the right-hand side, spawning in the red, it is Shrekt on Ice, Mongol on Kerrigan, Anubarak being played by Zyphiria, Phoenix on Uther, Dino on Stitches, and Abathur being played by Stolz. Ooh, I need to swap around my team names.
Snowflake does have to be very careful, because if you get caught by this team, there are so many stuns and pulls and hooks to keep you there. If you get caught once in the early game, that is where Team SOI is going to be depending on right now, is landing those hooks and making sure no one gets away. I mean, you got the hook, you got the Kerrigan pull, you got the Kerrigan stun, you got the Nubarak stuns, and then you got the Uther stuns. Like, you're not getting away from this team.
No, not at all. And that is actually a really good point, Zoya. But as he gets the Stitches hook, Idra gets absolutely CC'd down, as you were talking about, and gets eliminated. First blood going out here for Shrekt on Ice.
Shrekt on Ice, like we were talking about, they have a very aggressive playstyle. Even though I've only seen them play on the ladder, it's still their entire squad, and they are very brutal here. Let's see where the lane set up. We do have that Abathur in the bot lane. We have Kerrigan waiting in those bushes mid lane. We have Uther trying to soak the experience, and we have Stitches top. It looks like we're going to be having the Kerrigan, Anubarak, Rome squad, Faye, and Keelax being very safe down bottom. Not going to be able to secure a gank against these guys. They're letting the lane push up decently well, which is benefiting them at the moment.
Well, so, yeah, it's really good for Keelax and Faye to have that lane push, and that's why I'm really curious to see why Shrekt on Ice is trying to get a gank in on that area. I mean, yeah, they're going to get that shrine, and they're going to soak the XP, but if you're trying to get the gank, you need your the enemy team to be exposed. Snowflake coming out here in force, four guys coming down here, and it looks like Shrekt on Ice is going to have to back up. I'm not going to stop saying the name of their team.
Shrek Dawnite. We're going to be seeing a lot of this team Snowflake. They're going to have to keep roaming around as a team like this because each team can't control a watchtower on their own with the current lane setup they have. That's why LZ's down here right now, to make sure they can keep this lane. And that's part of the problem with Adequate on this map. It is a little bit more difficult for you to control the shrines when you don't have that fifth body.
Phoenix getting a little bit of engaged upon, going to push him out of range just for a little bit here for Shrek on Ice. They do have both of the shrines right now. Chilliwack and Dino are fighting at the top lane, but of course Stitches can come in here and help out Dino. Is he going to be able to do it is the question.
Chilliwack does have to end up backing out of there, and actually Kerrigan ends up going down there. Did not see the kill, and we have Zephyr getting a body block pretty well here, trying to secure that kill on Keelax. Does not actually get it, and it's something we didn't talk about. We did see that March the sub end up did stepping out as Keelax was around to show up, so Keelax is actually on their main roster, and he's in the game now.
Yeah, it's really weird how like Snowflake is really just kind of favoring just taking one of these shrines. They don't really want to get both of them just yet. It looks like they just want to get this dominant map control, but the thing that I'm really kind of getting bugged about, excuse my puns because Anubarak is on the map, is that they're not really doing that much. A really nice gank there on Idra, and that's going to give them that middle lane experience. LZ does have to respond by going up there. But they're not really using that much of this map control, you know? They've got this one defined shrine, but they're not really getting any type of real advantage by just soaking both these lanes. We're not seeing giants being taken by any teams, nor knights.
Yeah, that's something that I would expect Team Shrek on Ice to be doing a little bit more, is taking the camps. Kerrigan and Anubarak, with the Beatles on Anubarak, you can actually take camps fairly effectively, and that's not something we're seeing just yet.
Mm-hmm. Well, I mean, I think it's going to be a little bit more difficult for you to grab those camps with Abathur, because you're going to be sacrificing one person as well as your Abathur camp being late. Mongo getting really hardly engaged. Is he going to be able to get out of here? Yes, he is. It looks like LZ was just barely trying to get for that jump as well as hit Mongo with a small sliver of life that he had left, but he is going to get out of there. Stoll still pushing the lane pretty hard with those Locusts.
Yeah, that is a constant thing that you have to do with Abathur. You always have to keep that in mind. And in late game, when you get that more powerful Beatles, it is something that can actually take forts and stuff.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's, I mean, as soon as you get the Locust Swarm, Locust Swarm is so incredibly strong. And that's going to be only synergized really well with Anubarak's Beatles. It's, you know, it's just more and more critters that the enemy creep wave doesn't really have to, and kind of soaks damage, making your creep wave just stronger and stronger.
Well, giants are here. Keelax is going to be using his passive to try and keep on top of us as much as possible. Will Mangle and Zephyr go for it? And actually, we have blue team having both shrines right now, but Mongle will be able to cap it over. Idra not able to loot that here. And Zephyr actually getting pretty low right now. Has to be very careful. And red team hero killed. Uther did end up going down Idra and Elza Gamer snagging that kill in the middle. Kills 3-2 right now. Level 9 to level 8. And these giants are doing work, Bob.
Yeah, this is going to be a really difficult spot for Shrek on Ice to decide what they're going to do. Are they going to try and defend bot, or are they going to try and gain that middle lane back again? They're losing so much experience at the time, and it's going to be level 10 for Snowflake, very close, and they're only barely hitting level 9 just now.
This push is almost... it's going to be very hard for Shrek on Ice to stop. They have the two members here, Kerrigan and Phoenix, and then Abathur, of course, trying to help laying those landmines. They trying to peel away from it as much as possible. And we have Keelax teleporting top lane to help with the fight. Chilltech going ham here. Dino might end up going down. LZ does secure the kill. Level 10 has been acquired by Team Snowflake. LZ actually going in on Zephyr again, but not going to be able to do much. Taking a lot of tower damage there. Has to back off. Let's take a look at the heroics. Nothing out of order. We do see that Emerald Wind. We see the Odin, the Judgment, and the Shocker off.
Emerald Wind is always the biggest decision here. It's either Emerald Wind or you're going to be going for Blink Heal on Brightwing, and with such a heavy engaged team, Stitches and just about everybody else, Kerrigan as well, hard engaged, they have to be close to the enemy. Emerald Wind pushes everybody back and suppresses them, allowing your team to get those hits that they so desperately need. Phoenix taking so many hits is going to go down. Mongol unable to really do too much to really stop that from happening, and really I think Phoenix has taken a lot of deaths in this game so far. Yeah, he's already taken 2 deaths, but I mean, actually, I thought that was a little bit more in favor of Snowflake, but apparently it's not.
5 kills to 2, though, right now. Snowflake having that lead, 1 level advantage as well. Both teams do have their heroics. Let's just make sure nothing weird. Actually, we do see that the hook goes down. Dino gets the gorge. Will he get behind the wall? It does not look like Idris behind the wall. Immediately popping that Odin. Will he be able to save himself, though? Chen is here. Idris tumbles out. Helix comes forward here. Big shock and awe. Almost kills Mongo. Mongo doesn't fall. Avatar Clone is down as well. Dino gets behind the wall. What was looking like a potential kill on Idris ended up turning into a kill on Abathur, or on Kerrigan. And does not go the way that Shrek on Ice wanted. Actually, Dino getting pretty low here as well. Getting a little bit greedy here. Uther does fill him up, but not going down. A nice little engagement there from Snowflake. Good reaction from the team as a whole when Idra got hooked.
That was a really good advantage that Snowflake took advantage of. They had four members just floating around that area where Shrek on Ice only had three, so they knew that they could turn that engagement around really, really well because of the numbers advantage, and the numbers advantage alone is very good in this game. And as soon as they had that fourth person join in, they just knew that they could take that fight. Now it looks like we see Earth, Wind, and Storm coming in here. Gonna be taking a lot of damage on Mongo, but Faye gonna be completely focused down as all three members of Shrek on Ice that are in the middle lane are gonna focus her down. Idra trying to push everybody away. They do have the shrines, both shrines. Nothing can go grab the other shrines. Chill Attack just barely grabs the Dragon Knight, and it looks like there's gonna be a Dragon Knight in favor of Snowflake.
Ball size up to 10 seconds, he does that fly. LZ does get hooked and gets killed off. Great play there from Team Shrek on Ice. They want to focus our Chill Attack as much as possible. And this Mule is doing so much right now, keeping this turtle alive. They might not even get a wall with this dragon, and that's huge for this late in the game.
Oh, but they get the kick on Dino, which forces him into the middle of the map. That's actually going to... Oh, I thought it was going to save Idra, but it wasn't able to. But they do get the kill on Dino as well, so that's actually a really good pickup there for Snowflake. But still, this Dragon Knight has not been able to do that much other than that nice little nab there.
That Mule pick is doing wonders for Shrek on Ice right now. Level 13 is about to be required by them putting them on even levels. Kills are 7-5. Shrek on Ice is doing a great job of trying to keep themselves in this game. They'll have to keep making plays like that, though, if they want to get in this here. And here we go, Keelax getting focus fired down here. Big stuns, like we talked about.
You know, Zoe, you just said they need to keep making plays, and they're like, hey, you know what? That sounds like a really good idea. Let's do that. Let's do that plays thing. And seems like they took your advice and start making some good plays. They now have a numbers advantage down bot here, and they're going to keep making those good plays that you asked for. It's now 4-3, and it looks like this could be an engagement. LZ Gamer getting caught in the back. Does he have his ultimate up? Faye with a very nice shock and awe, but isn't enough to actually turn the tides of this battle because they do have the numbers disadvantage. Chill Attack coming in here, does get the judgment. Looks like he's going to be able to take down Anubarak. Mongo now being focused down. Is he going to go down? Yes, he is. Dino, the last member out here from Shrek on Ice, and he's going to get focused down as well. Snowflake walking away with a 4-0, and that's going to be a 4 for them.
Well, the thing about Chen is when he uses his heroic, his health bar gets changed. It's very similar to Odin, and you saw both LZ and Idra being the ones towards the front line there because they knew they had that second health bar. They had Brightwing about to come up so she could teleport in, and then they had Tyrael who could judgment in from above. That was a perfect engagement from Snowflake. They baited Shrek on Ice into that fight, and they capitalized greatly on it. They're almost level 16. They got the team wipe there. That was a beautiful play from Snowflake.
However, the pushing advantage out here with an Abathur on your team only gets way better once you hit level 16, once he gets those Swarm Locusts. Looks like there is going to be another engagement out here. Dino does get the Gorge, he polymorphs, he gets LZ Gamer behind, but that is actually a hero with a really good amount of escapes, but is it enough? LZ Gamer taking heavy hits, and he's going to go down.
And Keelix has to pop the Ice Block there. Divine Storm does not hit anybody. Will Keelix it away? No, does not get the Emerald Wind off. And again, it's that thing we talked about multiple times. There's just so many stuns, so many lockdowns. If you get caught, you are going to die more than likely. Mongo coming up from below. Will they be able to catch Idra? He does get the leap, but get the pull. The stun does not hit, though. Chill Tech using that smite to push him back. Great defense. And who? Big hook on Idra. Will it be enough to secure the kill, though? Kefir does land a stun. Uther not able to get in rage here, and Idra going to make it behind the wall. Chill Tech getting pretty low himself. And, oh, Abathur!
I just saw that there was a noodle kill up here by Faye. Oh, man. Viewers, if you don't know already, whenever anybody gets a kill on an Abathur, it's called a noodle kill. And it's pretty great.
I haven't
great.
Started doing that, but it's a thing now.
It's a thing. It's been thinging. Level 16 out here for Snowflake, and that's a really good advantage for them, especially with that Abathur kill. That means they have a little bit of solid map control for the next couple minutes. I mean, both teams are really just going to grab their knights, and it looks like Chill Attack is going to grab the bottom shrine. So now it's going to be a fight for the Dragon Knight in the middle. which means that all five members of SOI have to force this fight engagement and actually get a good engagement. They have the level 16 advantage out here for Snowflake.
Here we go, we see the Aftercloak goes on to Uther here. First, Divine Storm does go down. Mongo does use his Rogue, a big Emerald win there, and Zubin at the same time trying to segregate the team. Phoenix does sprint to the back. She'll take a damage here low here. He might end up falling here. He does have to flank back. Little poison kill him, and he does end up going down. LG Gamer in the back here. Helix has the eye block, needs to get out position. A big Uther stun. There's the pull. Will of Helix fall as well. Two kills so far, 2-1, and Zafira has to back off right now. It is a 3-4 right now in favor of Strict All Nice. Great fight from them so far. They're going to keep delaying here. Will they be able to get a stun onto Idra or LZ? They're going to have to keep delaying here, though, because they need someone to go into the shrines here. We have Dino taking the bottom shrine, and they can utilize that burrow on Abathur to take shrines as well now that the clone has fallen.
You know, if the 2-for-2 there and they deny the shrines, I'd have to say that's a very solid win out there for,
2-for-1.
Strict All Nice. 2-for-1. Sorry, yes. Very solid win here. They need to keep making these plays, though. They're still a little bit behind, but that's actually going to start having a turn around very quickly. 17 out here for both these teams. As long as they can keep this map control and they can start using Abathur to start heavily pushing these lanes with Swarm Locusts, I think they're going to be in a really good position to turn this game into a really solid win. As long as they can start getting these forts, they're still a fort down.
This is a lot closer than people probably would have expected. 13 kills to 11. Evil on levels as well, but the only difference is Snowflake has taken a single fort, putting the forts at 6-5. So we'll have to see what... I mean, outside of the Abathur, they don't have the best push right now. They have to really win a team fight or get a Dragonite if they want to take forts.
Yeah, they really don't have too many heroes that are great for pushing. I mean, Anubarak, Locusts are really good for that. But other than that, yeah, you're completely right. They don't have a ton of damage towards buildings. Somebody like a Tychus is really good for these types of things, but they don't really have that.
What did Dino take? Oh, so Dino's actually going Smash Stitches. Slam Stitches, sorry.
Which I think is exactly what they need. They needed that damage. They couldn't really go for like the more standard Stitches build. They needed the damage, the interrupt, etc. because, well, really they're already like completely overflowing with interrupt, but more interrupt is always better.
Take a look at the damage chart right now. Yeah, Stitches is currently second in damage on the whole game, right behind Faye. That's a very good point. You know, it just caught me a little off guard when I didn't see that fishing hook. You know, the fishing hook is usually taken by most Stitches, but it makes complete sense. A good choice from Dino to take those talents.
Incredibly good point. And look at this, they're actually grabbing that bottom fort, so now they're going to be a little bit equal, but it's whether or not they can actually keep this top fort. I don't think so. Five members out here for Snowflake.
Keep.
And yeah, that's going to be a 4-for-4, but unfortunately, you know, SOI's already down in forts. Is that trade
so
worth it?
5-for-4. I don't think so. I mean, you have to take the wins you can get, though. They wanted a little bit more map pressure. You know, bot lane is a good fort to take, just because if you can get a good Siege Giant push going, it can help you take an early keep. So I guess bot for top is not the worst decision, but I don't know. It's just so hard for them to push. You got to take it when you can get it. That was a bad way to phrase that, but yes.
Well, we do have the four people down here for SOI. I don't know if they're going to be really able to get an engagement. And what's really scary with the engagements for their team, because they have that Abathur, is they have to wait for Abathur to get those.
Ooh, LZ
much,
hook.
Oh, actually a really good hook, but it's LZ, it's a Chen.
Oh, wait, yeah,
it's
a Chen.
You don't ever really want to grab a Chen, because he can actually turn the fight around, but actually Snowflake being engaged comes pretty hardly. A really good shock at all coming out here from Faye, but LZ Gamer getting his Storm, Earth, and Fire getting focused down really quickly. First team member going down here on Snowflake. It's going to be a kill, but Anubarak also going to go down. And is he going to... Oh, I don't think they're going to be able to turn this fight around. Dino trying to get out, but he just barely got the symbiote on him, but the shield wasn't enough. Phoenix now the only survivor out here, except for the Abathur, but Abathur, again, with those Locusts, was able to take down the top fort. So actually, I'm going to have to say that was actually a pretty even trade. Getting the fort for getting three deaths. I mean, I know the experience
initially,
is much...
Initially, yes, but now that gave Snowflake a free dragon.
That's true.
And this is where they're going to capitalize off it. We'll have to see where they want to go. It looks like they just want to push mid lane, just get a little bit more map control. Overall, that was a great engagement for Strict All Nice, but it just didn't I don't know. I don't know where they went wrong with that. I mean, the Chen hook wasn't the most ideal thing, but it looked like they had the great initiation. Just, I guess, great overall position from Snowflake. They couldn't wombo them down a lot. So they do have a lot of AoE damage with the Stitches and the Kerrigan. And we saw Faye and Idra making sure they were on the edge of the fight the entire time.
I mean, Abathur's clone, I don't think, was up for that entire fight. So overall, it was just a 5v4, and that was
what Snowflake really took. Started the clone.
They did?
Started with an Uther.
Yeah. Oh, they did. Okay. An Uther clone is a very interesting choice. Double Divine Storm, I guess, makes sense, but at the same time, they don't really have the damage. I think they need somebody a little bit more damagey. Anyway, LZ Gamer now taking out a lot of damage on the towers and gate before the keep here. For Shrek on ice, a little bit of a missed hook out there from Dino, so he's going to be waiting on that cooldown.
Yep, and we do see that LZ is going to take down that wall. They're going to actually start beating on this keep, do some damage to Phoenix. They got 12 seconds and 43% HP left on this Dragonite here. Dino going to land a few more stuns here.
Is he going to get it? He gets it!
Oh,
Keelax in the back of the base. Stoles is able to get out, though.
This Abathur backdoor did actually a lot of damage to that keep, though. They're going to have to prepare for this the entire game. Look how low that keep is. It is almost destroyed.
I've seen this before. And we had no idea how to deal with it.
Yeah, this is a long time strategy. I think LZ Gamer might have been the first person to do it. He was the original Abathur player for the longest time, and I think he might have been the one.
I don't think LZ actually started doing this. I saw it after LZ's reign of Abathur. Okay.
I just know it's been around for a while, but you might be right. It might not have been LZ. We do have an engagement going down here. Still taking caught here. Will he be able to get out? He does get stunned, but he doesn't end up getting away. And Snowflake is in full retreat. Big pull goes down. LZ does get stunned, and he will not get out of that. Chen does end up falling, but we are level 20. Resurgence of the Storm. He is right back up. Abathur is back in here. He does get polymorph, and Abathur kill does go down, wanting to get that fort being a
noodle
little bit
kill.
Too greedy here.
But this is a really great strategy because this forces Keelax to stay in the back of the base. But as I'm saying that, there is an engagement going down here on Snowflake and Shrek on ice. But unfortunately, Keelax is, oh my god, his Emerald Wind pushed everybody from Shrek on ice out of the shock and awe there from Faye. And it looks like Phoenix is going to get taken down. Mongo going to go down. Is Dino going to go down? Zephyria is barely going to get away. But now Dino's stuck in the middle of all five members here for Snowflake.
Luckily for Snowflake, that miss shock and awe did not cost them any kills. That was the just worst timing for that Emerald Wind shock and awe. But yeah, the Abathur did end up dying. Great engagements from Snowflake. We do have double resurgence on both teams. We have Uther and Stitches from team Shrek on Ice, and then Tyrael and Chen have resurgence. For those of you that don't know, resurgence is a level 20 talent that I believe it's a 3-minute cooldown or two. When you die, you get the resin 5 seconds.
2:30. But anyway, as we're talking about that, there is a little bit of an engagement yet again. Shrek on ice being engaged upon. Dino taking heavy hits. His resurgence is down, but he is going to barely just get out of there.
Yep, do not want to die just yet. It's a reasonably short cooldown, so if you can kind of delay those fights until it is up, it can make a huge advantage in whether you can hold a keep or not. Faye gonna immediately bribe those giants, and we have four giants pushing bot lane. We have a few people from Shrek on Ice heading to that top lane, wanting to get that shrine, make sure that Snowflake doesn't get an easy giant. And right now, a lot of Shrek on Ice is a bit split up right now. And we have Abathur top lane doing a little bit of Locust pressure, really wants to get that keep. He is going hard for it.
Oh, Faye does fly in here. Is she going to be able to grab the shrine? She's not. Phoenix and Zephyria are here. They do miss a couple of their stuns, but it looks like they are going to get that kill on Falstad. That's going to give them a ridiculous amount of map control at this point.
And Keelax might end up going down here as well. The stun does end up hitting, and there's just so many stuns from this team that when you get caught out of position, it's so hard to get away. A two kills for nothing, and these are deaths that don't have resurgence. It is a 5v3 for 45 seconds. What can Shrek on Ice do?
You know, I don't know if they're using this correctly. They're trying to push this fort, but really they should be giving Abathur the ability to get back into the base here for Snowflake and take down that keep. He does have the little mine there, and it looks like that is what he's going to be doing very, very quickly. But he's got to be careful, because with the Dragonite, that's going to force Snowflake to get back into their base. So he has to be very careful, because Snowflake is now in a position to counter that really quickly.
That Dragonite at 21 minutes in the game, level 21.
1,000 damage hits.
1,000 damage hits. That is so insane. Giving up late game Dragonites is just so rough to deal with. You see Idra constantly in position. LZ, we're waiting for the Abathur Burrow. They are sitting here hiding. Look at you know Idra is waiting for that avatar. That's
he
all
is.
He's
sitting there. Well, yeah, exactly, waiting for it. But he's got to be careful. He can't go in just immediately. But it doesn't matter. This Dragon Knight's actually going to be able to take out this Keep already, and that's going to give them a really strong advantage. That's going to be an easy push lane out here for Shrek on Ice.
And first Keep of the game. That means Catapult will be pushing top lane for the rest of the game, guys. You know, in other MOBAs, when you take, you know, the inhibitor, those can eventually respawn, but not in this game. You are going to be constantly pushed by those minions. That's something that Snowflake's going to have on the back of their mind the entirety of this game. We've seen minions win matches before because the push just builds up too big.
Yeah, and I mean, that's... I mean, with more and more of the pushing advantage coming out here, they've got Anubarak's Beetles, they've got absolutely everything else. It looks like Snowflake's trying to edge for a fight. And Abathur's Locust, they're just in a really good position to keep pushing these lanes. But there is a huge advantage coming out here from Snowflake as they got a lot of hits in before the keep went down. Strike on Ice was trying to get that keep down no matter what. They do grab the Uther. Stoll's trying to get out of here, but I mean, he is just an Abathur clone, so it doesn't really matter that much. They lose two members, but one of them had Resurgence. And not both only that, but they got a keep. They got two
both
keeps.
Both of them had Resurgence.
Both Uther and Stitches. You're right. Uther and Stitches are back up again, so...
Keeps, though, and nothing Snowflake can do to capitalize right now. They have to use so many of their heroics in those team fights to be able to take wins against this team. And, I mean, how can they capitalize right now? They got to defend against the Catapults pushing top lane. There's one thing I did want to point out about that last fight, though. Killex had a really great Emerald Wind that pushed a lot of the members back into them. That helped them secure those two kills, but... Oh man, Resurgence is too strong.
Yeah, and I don't know if you noticed this, Zoya, but there is a mine in the back of Snowflake's base yet again.
Where is it? Where?
Right behind the only keep that's left. As soon as they get an idea that Snowflake doesn't have all five members in the base, that Abathur is going straight for there.
We'll have to wait and see when he does that, bro. We'll keep an eye on the minimap for you guys.
Oh, he just burrowed top. Okay, that's weird. He's going to try and counter out those knights, and I think that's actually a pretty strong decision. Meanwhile, Strucked on Ice going to grab the bottom giants.
Really early Stitches, Abathur clone. Really quickly, so they're wanting to make something happen here, Fist, because Abathur clone is on a timer, guys. And here we go, Stitches coming forward here. Will he land the gorge? We have to get him going down. Emerald Wind going down in a really weird position, only really hitting one person there. Here comes the big play here. Oh, Chiltek pushing the Shock and All out of the way here. And all of Snowflake seems to be in opposition. Kerrigan is already dead, though. Keelix does hit that ice block here. Will be able to focus down one of the Stitches. Keelix does get stunned. Zen Afira is going to have to back off from Idra. He was winning that fight. Right now, Snowflake is winning. Big hook on Idra, though. Will he be able to back out, though? Keelix trying to keep his team online. He's doing a great job of it. Arthur Cone falls. Dino ends up falling as well. Resurgence is up for him, though, and Kerrigan, though, does not have that Resurgence. They're going to be able to clean up these giants. Another win for Snowflake. Can they make something happen 5v4?
You know, that engagement was really not going so well for Snowflake in the very beginning. Shock and Awe only hit one person. Emerald Wind only hit one person. They missed a lot of their key abilities, but the rotation out there from Snowflake was really well. I mean, the damage was just distributed perfectly between everybody to the point that... Not all of the damage was distributed so perfectly amongst Shrek on Ice, and that was why they were able to get such a good advantage. Unfortunately, Faye tried to fly top by herself, and she did get picked up there by Shrek on Ice. I'm sorry, I did miss that.
For those of you that are new to Heroes, this is not a normal game, guys. This is very weird and going longer than the average game time here. This is definitely an interesting Dragon Shard map, and LZ is getting chased. The Slam Stun does go down. Abathur trying to poke at him as much as possible here. Kerrigan has not covered the team just yet. Is LZ actually going to fall to this?
Oh, he's getting CC'd to hell, and he's going to get taken out. The Gorge coming out here on Chillicheck. Is he going to be able to get his Herodric? Oh, no, he's not. His Q did not save him, and neither did his trait do any damage. So now they're at a pretty good spot. Unfortunately, there is a Resurgence there on Chillicheck for Shrek on Ice. So they won't be able to get too much of an advantage, but it looks like they are going to be vying for that Dragon Knight.
Oh man, I don't think, like, I'm looking at this logically. We have Dino being caught a little bit off guard here. Keelix is getting in position for the Emerald Wind, but it's looking bad for Snowflake. I mean, when I'm looking at these team fights and seeing how, like, when we first saw this team comp from Shrek on Ice, we were a bit curious about it. We talked about the stuns, but that's it. But I mean, Snowflake's in a really rough position. This is going to be such a hard win for them. They're going to have to pull some SMG backdoor stuff after a huge teamfight win if they want to win this.
Yeah, they're going to have to get a massive teamfight while all of the resurgences are down. There is a huge fight at the Dragon Knight. There is an Odin coming down here. The big red button does hit a lot of members of Shrekt on Ice. Mongo now trying to focus down LZ Gamer by himself. Helax using Sprint, trying to get out of here. Is he going to be able to stay alive? Yet another big red button hitting Phoenix in the face. Dino actually not taking too many hits. And that's something they need to fix. Helax very low in health. And it looks like they are going to be able to turn this fight around here for Snowflake. Though they are pretty low in health. Dino finally looking like he's going to go down. Maybe? Oh, Chilatek does pop out of the gorge. And Faye coming in here at the very end and does get the final hit.
God, LZ is getting killed by two Uthers right now. He's solo and he does end up falling. He does not have Resurgence left. It is now a three versus three with that Resurgence. God, Resurgence makes some games just so ridiculously hard to end. We do have top shrine being taken by Chilltech. LZ or Faye might try and fly bottom at, but she has to clear off the push top, and we will not be seeing a Dragonite here from Team Snowflake. Abathur being able to never die, and then you have the two Resurgence. You have to get a complete wipe if you're Snowflake, if you want to make anything happen. The thing is, though, when it's this late in the game at level 24, almost 25, if you get that opportunity to end, you can easily push across the map because you have a minute to do so, and the damage is so high from these guys. All it takes is that one engagement from either team, and they can end the game. It just keeps trading back and forth. 28 kills to 20 right now.
And there's the mine again. Zoya, the mine is back.
The mine is back.
All that matters to me right now is the Abathur mines.
You know, that's a great place for that mine, because when Abathur burrows in, he's got the dock just in case he wants to take a moment to go fishing. That is there's fish in that lake. You can actually see them.
He'd scare the hell out of that villager who's fishing there, though.
You know,
that poor little guy.
He looks like I'm just gonna be no fluff. He looks like he's seen some shit. He might not be too scared. That fisherman, he's got some trouble times right now.
The human peons. They sound so broken and everything because they've seen such horrible things.
Yes, me lord. Righto. The absolutely everything's gone wrong for me.
Top shrine being taken by Team Shrekt on Ice. That's gonna give them control of the Dragon Knight if they can go to that mid lane and get it. Team Snowflake is sitting here waiting for it. Will they be able to make something happen? I mean, when do you think is the moment that Shrekt on Ice just goes straight SMG and goes for that core? Do you think there's ever a moment you do it, or do you just have to wait for the perfect team fight?
You need to have that advantage. You have to have the numbers advantage. They haven't had real numbers advantage coming out of most of their team fights just because of Resurgence, just because of who they killed and how they killed them. And that's really the moment that you decide that you're going to be able to do it. As soon as you have, even a 5v4 that's deterministic that you're going to win the next team fight is when you can go and do it. But until you have that point, I mean, it's just really scary. They are going to grab the knights, though, so that's going to give them a little bit more advantage because they already have knights pushing that top lane. And the more and more pushing power they have on one lane means that they can put pressure on another.
What they're going to do is use these knights to delay. They're going to swing bot lane and try and take that shrine. We're going to see how Snowflake reacts. Is Faye going to fly top lane to try and take that shrine? She is defending against the knights right now. We have Snowflake in position in the mid lane, potentially wanting to force a fight here. Knights are still pushing that core, though.
And that's exactly what they want. If Abathur actually goes back and uses his swarm host with those knights, that's going to do a lot of core damage. Idra does get gorged. Are they going to be able to chain the CC? Here comes absolutely everything out here from Snowflake. Idra getting heavy hits. Shane getting Faye getting the shock and all. Does a lot of damage. Helax using a very good Emerald Wind. Going to separate much of Shrekt on Ice, but isn't going to be enough. A very good Divine Storm comes down. LZ Gamer's Storm, Earth, and Fire actually taking a lot of hits, but it's still up. It means he's going to be able to come out and be able to be still a pretty good member of the team fight. But Shrekt on Ice. The hook
pull does go down. LZ Gamer does end up falling. That is currently a 1-for-2 right now. Chen does have Resurgence. Chilltech does try and delay this as long as possible. Great job from Faye taking that shrine and preventing that Dragonite. And both the members of Snowflake that died did have, or two of the members that died, two of the three, had Resurgence. So a 3-for-1, but two of them are already alive, making it still a 4-versus-4.
Dino does grab the top DK shrine.
I think they got this.
I think as long as they play this perfectly, the only thing is that they're going to have the defender's advantage out here for Snowflake because Idra's up in 9 seconds, and that means he's going to be right at the fight. However, Zyferia is going to be so far away because he's going to be a Nubarak. He has to fly all the way over to Snowflake's base. But at least they could possibly get this key. Maybe. Well, actually, Steve, they seem like they have a little bit of indecision.
It's a tough call to make, man, because all it takes is one bad decision. You waste the Dragonite, or you potentially wipe and lose the game. It's that stressful of a situation. 31 minutes in, think of how fast that core would die just from auto attacks.
Mm-hmm.
It's so tense right now. Looks like they're wanting to push bot lane. They still have over a minute. The longer the game going, the longer you have that DK. So they have plenty of time here. It looks like they were maybe wanting to just wait for that Nubarak to catch up with the team, and they are pushing bot lane. They want to take that final core or a final keep, and I don't know if Snowflake can do anything to stop it.
Well, here comes the clone out here from Abathur. Mongol taking a lot of hits from Snowflake. Helix does use his ice block. Idra is in the back lane. They need to get Idra. They need to get Faye. They need to take out those heavy hitters for Snowflake. And if Strekton Ice is able to do it, doesn't matter, actually. They're going to go straight for his chill attack. Remember, Mongol at this point is doing 1,400 damage a hit in that Dragonite. LZ Gamer trying to shield it, but the last keep does go down. Snowflake in a really bad position. Helix does get grabbed. And he's going to get taken out, and this is going to be 5-4-3.
No resurgence off on that Tyrael, and that Dragonite is slapping the core for 1440 damage. It is melting so fast. They're trying to lay, but I don't think they can do it in time. That core is at 40%. The shotgun auto goes down. Mongo is just going straight for that core, and GG Shrek on Ice takes game number one in what, in my mind, is a huge upset.
Hold on.
Kevin.
Give me a second.
We're waiting for Kevin's production. What is happening?
What just happened?
Wow,
that was this really good team fight.
Is not something we've ever seen before in the history of a competitive scene. So many stuns. The slam stitches has never been busted out at such a level. What an insane team. We were questioning it from the get-go. You know, we saw the Kerrigan pick, which is okay. And then we saw the Stitches Abathur. And that was, or the Nubarak and Abathur, and that was weird. And we saw the Stitches pick. What a weird comp, and they made it work. 32-minute game, and Strekton Ice takes it. What's the next map, man? What's the next map?
They said it in chat, I remember. Hold on. It was...
Reddit formatting.
Cursed. Cursed and Haunted, if we get up to the best of three. Unless Strekton Ice is able to take this round. Now, yes, you are completely right. This team... I was like, this doesn't make any sense to me. The Stitches wasn't so much the... we expected the hard engages using Kerrigan and Anubarak kind of going in and doing everything. And-